So in the next 5 to 10 years, for the next pandemic, we'll solve all those problems.
You say the next pandemic, there will be another pandemic.
Absolutely, we don't know when. You know, the risk per year, 2%, 3%.
Most of the work we're gonna do to be ready for pandemic two, I call this pandemic one, we'll build a set of tools within 8 to 10 years and a surveillance capacity at the global level, which will mean that for a pathogen like this, you know, we pay, you know, 1% of the price that we did this time. And next time, we are really going to have some good vaccines that, you know, we'll understand the duration and we won't have breakthrough cases. You know, this was an interesting trust, case test of people's trust in their politicians or their health system. Statistically, we didn't do as well as I would have expected.
You try to warn us about this pandemic, and we didn't listen. What's the next thing you're warning us about that's going to happen 5 years from now that we're not listening to at the present?
Well, I didn't want to be right. What I wanted to do is...
I understand. I'm not saying you won. Everybody loses. Nobody wins with us. And I'm not saying that you're this is not an end zone dance. I'm just saying, what else are we not listening to that we need to take action on now?
Well, the idea of a bioterrorist attack is kind of the nightmare scenario, because they're a pathogen with a high death rate would be picked. Now, the good news is, I'm not trying to depress you. It's tough enough.
Too late.
Right now.
Too late.
You know, in fact, you know, I'm cited as some, you know, mastermind of some evil plot. You know, I hope vaccine acceptance for other diseases like measles is not reduced by this.
Dr. Fauci and I knew that there was a possibility that in 12 months we would have the vaccines. No one had ever made an mRNA vaccine.
Stay safe.
All right. Great talk.
Give our best to everybody else in the bunker.
Thank you.